शो का कोई नाम है?
नहीं, डिड फील वही पेट में किसी तो ना किसने मुक्का मारा हो. आई बोथ कंपनी विद अदर पार्टनर्स.
अरे पास में बैठे हुए मतलब ऐसे कैसे
ऐसे ना. Hi guys, welcome to my channel. मैं हूँ अनुप्रिया कपूर and आज का जो वीडियो है is something which is very close to my heart, something that I've been wanting to actually talk about for a while now. It's basically about co-parenting. It's about हमारे society में divorce को लेके बहुत taboo है and I've been very vocal about destigmatizing divorce and probably having conversations around divorce. And also the importance of being amicable and respectful to your ex-partner, especially if children are involved. And I have Pratham with me and he obliged us. Thank you so much because I'm not sure if this is in your comfort zone or not to be making a video like this.
I'm good. I think I'm good so far. Since yeah. You're doing most of the talking, I'm fine.
No, you would be doing a lot of talking as well. Okay. So we'll keep it very conversational. हमने AMA किया था on Instagram, so I would be taking up questions. I feel that will give a structure to this video. So over to you.
Yeah. No, I kind of feel strongly about this myself. I feel strongly about this, not as I sort of went this or walked this path, but I think I feel more strongly about it gauging people's reactions since I've walked this path. So the concept of co-parenting or the idea of co-parenting is not something that sort of is a concept I knew and decided to sort of work towards. It's something that we did organically. There was nothing, there was no two ways about it. But that there should be conversations and positive conversations around it is something I realized only when I started gauging people's reactions, or the fact that they were weirded out by this is when I felt strongly about having conversations around it.
Correct. It was like ki jab proceeding ho rahi thi, humne is bare mein socha bhi nahi ki would kabhi be spending time here or kabhi would be spending time there. It was just so natural ki obviously both of us are going to be equally involved in his upbringing. Matlab sawal hi nahi tha ki one of us is going to bring him up. We both wanted to do it together. We'll always be parents. That's how I think we look at it, ki hum chahe if we are not together as partners, but we'll always be joined with one thread, and that's Kabir. And nothing is going to change that.
Yeah.
The other thing we had, okay, Chutki, can you move? So the other thing we had decided was to, in fact, around the time jab divorce ho raha tha, hum log, I remember we had a conversation to never let ego in.
Yeah.
Ki hum log ke relationship mein jo bhi hua, jo it did not work out for whatever reason, but उसकी वजह से कबीर पे कभी भी थोड़ा सा भी इम्पैक्ट नहीं आना चाहिए. जो भी हमारे डिफरेंसेस हैं वो रहेंगे, नहीं हैं सॉर्ट आउट होंगे, बट दे विल नॉट कम व्हेन देयर इज एनीथिंग टू डू विद कबीर. एंड आई थिंक दैट रियली हेल्प्ड अस इवन सॉर्ट आउट आवर डिफरेंसेस इन अ लॉट ऑफ वेज. वी मूव्ड ऑन क्विकली फ्रॉम द डिफरेंसेस. आई फील एक और चीज थी आई वॉन्टेड टू से, बिकॉज लॉट ऑफ पीपल इन फैक्ट इन आर वेरी क्लोज सर्कल फाइंड इट वेरी वियर्ड दैट व्हेन यू कम टू इंडिया यू एक्चुअली कम एंड स्टे विद अस. एंड अगेन दैट्स समथिंग वेरी नेचुरल बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट कबीर टू स्पेंड एज मच टाइम एज पॉसिबल विद हिम. एंड ये भी नेचुरल है, राइट? मतलब दुश्मन थोड़ी बन गए हैं. या इन फैक्ट if at all we become better friends than we were even before, the way we are able to talk about our concerns and issues. In fact, jab mere work mein kabhi bahut zyada stress hota hai, I call you and I rant.
Yeah.
And similarly, I think a lot of times you've called me, in fact because I understand your nature of work, you've even called me and taken some
advice.
So yeah. And it's very natural. It's not something which we force. It's not something which we plan. It's just how it flows. It's how naturally we are.
Yeah, and look, I mean, visitation rights are a thing, and you know, depending on the ecosystem of where they live, it may not be possible for everybody. But the most that couples can do, they should, to keep it as easy going, as fluid as possible for the child. Now, I understand there are some, like, the couple might want it, but the settings that they live in may not allow for it and those kind of things. So there could be, people could have those challenges, but to the best that, you know, divorced couples can, I think they should try to make spaces which are sort of as normal, and that extends to even visitation rights, I feel.
Yeah, especially where I feel, jahan, you know, if it's an abusive marriage or if it was a toxic relationship, I still understand. But if it was something which did not work out for a certain reason, and if you have amicably parted ways, I feel co-parenting can be done with effort, of course.
Sure. Sure.
And I feel honestly, for the sake of the child, it should be done. So we will start taking the questions. I'll just read. So the first question that I got was, do you date other people and are you both comfy with other partners? So I'm going to take this first because I know that he's been committed in a relationship, and touch wood, it's going great. The only thing I would like to say is ki jab pehli bari mujhe pata laga tha, to honestly I did feel like पेट में किसी होता ना, किसी ने मुक्का मारा हो, तो वैसा करके एक फीलिंग आई थी केव्ड इन वाली. बट ऑफ कोर्स ओवर टाइम आई थॉट अबाउट इट रैशनली एंड आई वाज एक्चुअली हैप्पी दैट ही फाउंड समवन. एंड द ओनली थिंग आई हैड एट दैट टाइम थॉट वाज कि द पर्सन शुड बी गुड, द पर्सन शुड बी अ ग्रेट ह्यूमन बीइंग एंड नथिंग एल्स मोर देन दैट. एंड या आई एम एक्चुअली वेरी वेरी हैप्पी विद हाउ इट्स प्रोसीडिंग.
So for me, I look at it in a slightly, it's not just about your choices in dating and having partners or having a life partner for that matter, from this point onwards. But I look at it as your choice in everything. So for me, Kabir won't be raised right if you're unhappy. And so whatever you do for your happiness is important for me. That you're able to make your choices with material things, relationships, finances, everything. So, I mean, dating is just one thing. And so, for me, I'd be very happy to see you dating or doing whatever you please, because that ensures that, you know, Kabir is being raised by someone who's happy and content with whatever she does.
And we were discussing today that, you know, online dating बहुत मुश्किल है, especially now I'm 40 and I don't even know how to adapt to that change. तो immediately तो हम सोचे नहीं हैं. Okay, next question. How do you deal with people who might think you have moved on too soon after divorce?
It's never crossed my mind, to be honest. It just doesn't
matter.
See, people. I've come to realize that there is a lot of negativity associated with divorce anyway. So uske fir subcategories kya hain ki kis exact cheez ko lege, you know, they're hating on me, or you. For me, in the entirety of this whole thing called divorce, what really matters is what my immediate family thinks and, you know, Kabir thinks, you think. That's it.
As far as I'm concerned, a woman gets much more flack, much more judgment from the society. I was labeled a bitch by people who love me or who are very close to me. So initially it was very, very tough. Emotionally it was very tough because log aise jo society mein jo jante wante, wo bhi mujhe aise dekhte the ki या तो मैं मर गई हूँ या मेरी लाइफ में कोई मर गया. एंड आई एम नॉट एग्जैजरेटिंग इवन वन बिट. एनी वुमन हु इज वॉचिंग दिस हैज गॉन थ्रू समथिंग लाइक दिस वुड रिलेट टू इट. मतलब मुझ पर या तो दया आती, पिटी, यू नो, कि ओहो वैसा वाला, या कि ये तो, यू नो, इसी में कुछ प्रॉब्लम है, ये औरत अच्छी नहीं है वाला फीलिंग. So very early on, I basically cut off a lot of people who I thought did not mean well. And बहुत मतलब मैंने इतने लोगों को हटाया अपनी ज़िंदगी से, and I started hanging out with very close people. People who genuinely mean well for me are the only ones. उसमें भी गलतियाँ की हैं मैंने, ऐसा नहीं है, but हाँ slowly I've learned, and after so many years I think I'm in a place where I am able to assess कि कौन ऐसा सोचता है और उसको मैं immediately अपनी life से हटा देती हूँ.
I mean, I was in a self, I mean, if I think of those early years since the divorce, I was in a self-preservation mode. So I was just busy working on how I feel about the whole thing, with very little time to think about what others are thinking, to be honest.
So that's actually a good way to be.
Yeah.
I'm not that like that. Yeah. Did you consult any marriage counselor, counselors? If yes, can you share their contact? Actually, no, we did not.
The divorce lawyer we worked with was very, she was a very nice person to talk to. I mean, just besides the legal, matters that she helped with, but she was also a very kind, nice person to talk to. And I think that was help enough, and the rest was just, you know.
She had even predicted that we'll get married again.
She's just such a nice person. You know?
Not to me, okay? Yeah. By the way, we had a common divorce lawyer.
Hmm.
And for some reason, she also decided to think that I'm the bad person.
I didn't realize
yeah,
that.
And she gave me a lot of cold shoulder. She would not respond to me, or she would not even directly talk to me. She would only interact with Satin. So, yeah.
Aisa kyun hai? No, but I mean, the one person who I actually, this will seem really funny, but the one person who knew, so we had not spoken to a lot of family members, some friends she had spoken to, I hadn't even. I had kept the whole entire thing to myself. I don't know if that was a smart thing or not. So the only person that I was really consulting is actually her. So, she gave me a lot of advice during that time. And I think she helped, in some ways also helped me come out of it during that time.
How did you decide on who stays as primary caregiver, mom or dad? How did you set the legality?
Again, it's very hard to answer these kind of questions because I know people are probably asking, well, actually, I don't know. But I mean, I just feel like it's our journey, right? And in that, we never really discussed this. It just, you know, she is the smarter parent, and so it just made sense and we also felt like she is again in an ecosystem where he'll be raised better versus me who's kind of moving away from the household.
Yeah.
So it just made sense. We didn't discuss this really.
It was like a natural thing. We decided that, you know, it will be better for Kabir because anyway we were working in the Philippines, so for him to move is something we did not think of because, you know, it's kind of uprooting him.
Yeah.
And we didn't want to do that. So wo thought bhi shayad se pura ka pura hi abhi, matlab when I look back, was based on Kabir.
Yeah.
Ki, you know, we don't want to disrupt his life.
I mean, if I have to think of it as, I mean, it's easy to talk about my journey, but hard to give advice. And so if I'm pushed to a corner to give an advice, I'd just say that, you know, I mean, it really is a matter of which of the parent in the relationship has a better ecosystem and better capabilities, if all things considered, financial and everything else. I mean, just the house, the setup and everything. Who's in a better environment to provide for the child? I mean, not provide as in financially. Financially, ideally, both should. But just as an ecosystem, who is better situated should be the parent taking care of this.
The other thing was during the final, on the last day, the judge did ask me, you know, what if Kabir wants to move to his dad? Because we opted for co-parenting legally. And I was like, it's his choice. After all, you know, at a certain point, he should be able to make that choice, and I'm no one to stop him. from doing that. If this that is what will make him happy, so that's how it should be.
तुमसे बिल्लियां दूर चली जाएगी होता नहीं है तो बेटा चला जाएगा कैसे?
हाँ ये मुझे नहीं पता कि अगर इस बात पे आता कि you know you were fighting to get Kabir तो शायद से मैं
no but this thing about you know Kabir will make the choice and Kabir will make
हाँ मैं अभी बोल पा रही हूँ ऐसे but हाँ I know it's not going to be like so easy as I'm saying it but I would still respect his choice. चाहे वो दिल टूट जाए चाहे मैं मतलब यू नो बॉलीवुड की रोती हुई माँ बन जाऊँ बट आई विल स्टिल लेट हिम डू व्हाट ही फील्स लाइक. व्हाट डिड यू टेल प्रिपेयर द चाइल्ड हाउ इज दिस गोइंग टू वर्क?
या दैट ऑब्वियसली वाज द हार्डेस्ट पार्ट हार्ड टू द पॉइंट
वेरी टफ
हार्ड टू द पॉइंट वेयर आई एक्चुअली वाजंट आई वाज व्हेन वी डिसाइडेड टू शेयर दिस विद हिम आई वाज physically unwell I had because of this it triggered me to the point where I was physically unwell in trying to tell him that. So and I know there are people who I've seen comments out there where people think we are super cool about it and that we are fashionably divorced or whatever people have to say, which is all weird. Fact is I was actually I got sick in my efforts to try and tell him that we've divorced. So it was hard on me and she took the lead. You want to tell how you went about it?
Yeah, so I remember that we had taken a vacation and we had decided we're going to tell Kabir about it. Even though it had been a couple of years of the separation, we decided to tell him and it was official.
Yeah.
And because he was not able to, at that time he was too overwhelmed and was not able to start the conversation, I initiated the conversation where I broke the news and I decided to speak to him like he's an adult.
Yeah.
Like not that, and just before that to prepare myself also I had spoken to a couple of people who've gone through something like this. So that kind of helped me. I also read a lot online on how to say something like this or how to have this conversation, and that also actually a lot of blogs actually helped me. And I was very honest with Kabir that that you know we are not together as partners but we are and will always be together as parents for him, and that he will always be safe with us.
Yeah.
Was the main point of the conversation, and that's I think after that conversation is when you joined the conversation and we asked him if he has any questions and
So I mean some of the I remember sort of as the you know follow up conversation with Kabir, I remember telling him a few things about how I remember telling him about how, you know, you'd rather have a family that is, which is the crux of the whole point here that she tries to tell everybody is, you'd rather be with parents living separately but happy with the child versus living with the child, both parents living with the child but in a unhappy, evidently unhappy family. And I was just talking to a 10-year-old, and yet that's the only way to talk, even if it's a 10-year-old, that you know you got to, I mean you can't think that the child won't get it. I mean you know you have to appeal to their sensibilities. I mean, their higher sense, and they get it.
And they're far more resilient than what we give them credit for.
Yeah, true. And we spoke. I mean, I remember talking to him about even statistics. I mean, I told him that you know you can Google and find out for yourself how many divorces there are in India. What's the divorce rate in India? What's the divorce rate in other parts of the world? He can check for himself. And he, at that point in time, I know for a fact that he knew of a few of his classmates.
His best friend. Actually.
Yeah, his best friend. His classmates whose parents were going through a not so pleasant divorce or had gone through a not so pleasant divorce. and he was aware of that. So I sort of, I mean, as shady as this might sound, but I took leverage of that, saying that, look, I mean, there are cases like that. So what's worse, you know, parents in that situation, or would you rather have, you know, we talking to you amicably and telling you that, so this has already happened, this has been in the making for the last 2 years, but have we as parents in any way shortchanged you? You know, are you, do you feel like as parents you're not getting what other children get from their parents? And to those questions, I think his answers, the answers to those questions is what I think made him feel all right. Frankly, and I told him this, that, you know, if at any point in time, because of how he sees himself in comparison to other children, how he sees our family in comparison to other families, if he has any questions, he should ask. And I think we were overly conscious, even to a point where, I think to a fault, right? Like, we used to, in the smallest of things that he would be sad about, we used to think, oh, ye to broken family syndrome hai, you know, something to do with the fact that, you know, he's living in a family of this sort, which is causing it. So we were very, very watchful
of any signs.
Yeah, we were very, very careful, but at the same time, we didn't let it become.
We didn't overcompensate.
Yeah, we didn't overcompensate it in any way at all. But we were very careful. We were very vigilant.
I think the other thing that has helped, that helped at that time, is because Kabir loves reading.
Yeah.
And वो बहुत सारी किताबें पढ़ता था. So they were in the modern fiction. You do have families who are either divorced or who have, you know, or are single parents. So I have a feeling that somewhere that also helped.
Yeah. I mean, absolutely. I mean, you can't take away the role of literature and arts in,
absolutely,
you know, evolving thoughts in people, including children.
Can the divorce be reconsidered for the sake of the kid? Growing up without a father, mother is hard. I think the previous question, kind of, we discussed this, that, you know, I honestly don't see how two unhappy people can make good parents. But yes, if through therapy, the differences can be worked out and it can be resolved to the extent ki tum actually ek saath khush ho as a unit, then yes.
Yeah.
But otherwise, just like it said, for the sake of the kid, I don't think that's a good idea.
Yeah. I mean, whatever is your motivation, if you can genuinely be happy, sure. But if you think otherwise,
if you're forcing it,
faking it, just makes no sense.
Who has the final say in case of tough decisions for the kid?
Yeah. No, I mean, obviously the person on the ground.
We discuss ground. Always.
Yeah.
And uske baad, usually you do rely on my intuition, because I am present in the situation.
Yeah.
But there are a lot of times when I am completely stuck and I don't know what to do.
Yeah.
And I just say, you know, take over.
I mean, there have been times where my suggestion has prevailed, but that's again just because it was the better suggestion. It's nothing to do with this. We haven't decided who will take decisions. That's
basically, I think, again, isme wahi hai ki ego nahi hai. Agar aap ego ko hata do, to kafi cheeze rational ho jaati hai, and then you take the decision what is the best for the situation.
Right.
And I feel that's been our way.
Yeah.
How did your parents' social circle react to the co-parenting state? I think बहुत time लगा आसपास वाले लोगों को समझने के, and सिर्फ वही matter करते हैं, to be honest, कि वो जो आसपास के गिने चुने 4-5 लोग जो important हैं, उनको समझ आ जाए ठीक है, उनको ना भी समझ आ जाए तो भी ठीक है, as long as they accept it, they don't, you know, make our life difficult, which they don't.
I mean, it's a bit of a journey for them as well, right? I mean, it's not just about us. It is about, I mean, it's the families that came together when you get married. I believe in that. And so, yeah, it wasn't a very easy thing for, I think, the families to accept, and I understand that. But fortunately, in their cases also, I mean, and after all, we are from those families, and if we can be sensible, so can our families. And over time, they've come around to see what we're doing.
Again, I think communication is very key, because yeah. When we talked about this, you know, at the end of the day, the kids should not get impacted. Like in case of your brother and your sister-in-law, we actually had a conversation and we decided the kids will keep meeting, we will meet as families, and I think that's worked out in our case, at least I feel very beautifully.
Yeah, so my side of the family, if I can call them that, I think almost every year Diwali is here.
Correct.
Yeah.
And your mom, I mean, she passed away this year due to COVID, but she would still, you know, cook for me.
Yeah.
And for Kabir, of course. So it's been touch wood. We've been blessed like that.